Sup y'all, Homelander here, being late for another review. I swear I will complete it one day, and as of right now, I will be reviewing Money in the Bank. Okay, first match is the women's ladder match. This is an average ladder match, the women actually risk a body in here then softing things up just to look lethal. It's not that extreme, but they did put their body on the line and the match ended with a different yet deserving winner. Liv Morgan waited a moment and now she have it and will be fulfilled later on. This match is a 3.25 out of 5. Second match is Bobby Lashley vs Austin Theory for the United States Championship. It's just an ordinary match that give both of them some offense to spare. Austin Theory in here despite being a coward, he did good with Lashley, not gonna lie. So yeah, I'm pretty happy Lashley achieved something on this pay-per-view and this match gets a 2.75 out of 5. Next match is Bianca Belair vs Carmella. This match is boring, you can tell Carmella is not capable of keeping up with Bianca Belair's attributes and she's way below her skill set to keep up. Those offenses is the only thing stands out for her and she's not a good contender at all, in my opinion. This match is 2 out of 5. Alright now, this is a good show stealer. Both of these tag teams are on point of what they are doing in the ring on a fast phase match. Near falls after near falls, the crowd are popping for both teams for the quality of a match they had. Ending of the match is not that clean, but that's how you set up a rematch in terms of actual purposes. The Usos pick up the win and Street Profits remain strong. This match is incredible and I will give it a 4.25 out of 5. Okay, we have a boring match. That happens when you include Natalia, thinking she's a veteran capable of a technical masterpiece. This don't work and this is raw as fuck, so this match is a 1.5 out of 5. After the match, Liv Morgan cashed in and claimed her prize on the same night. I heard the prophecy was true.
The prophecy was true! He is the chosen one!
Never mind, the dork said this a year later. This is well deserved and you can hear the crowd was rooting for her. The only problem I have on this match is that we have the same cash in under 24 hours for over 5 years now. I'll show you. This is pure repetitive. So we finally get to the main event and it's actually good. Most Money in the Bank ladder matches are good anyways. So this wasn't a surprise. The psychology and phasing of this match is well constructed. Most of them have a good role in the match itself. There are good spots here and there. You have the wrestlers targeting Omos for their advantages and strategy. Including this sacrificial spot. My dear Omo Sapiens. Our Lord Omo shall be sacrificed for his sins, so his faith is the hands by the table. So the match goes on, you have Riddle doing ridiculous spots and almost claiming his victory and he have been stopped by Theory, getting the victory for himself and earn it on the fly. I have no problem with the winner even though it's too early in my opinion. I think someone else who isn't even in the match deserved it the most. But anyways, this match is very good and it deserves a 4 out of 5. This event's build up is so bland and forgettable. There's no hype for this pay-per-view at all. All the hype goes to the UFC, even the boss attended the UFC event. This is how poorly treated this event is and they better do better in the future. Overall rating of this pay-per-view is a 6.25 out of 10.